Hello guys, how are you? It has been a while since I have gone live and I'm so good to touch base with you again. So hope all of you guys are doing okay. I feel people joining and one of the comments is like, oh, I'm waiting. Similar to Vijay dialogue, I'm waiting. That is what Omicron is saying, I think so. Okay, good, perfect. All right, I'm going to start the live session by sharing a presentation with you. And then, you know, moving forward, I'll take some questions as well. So let's just quickly brief about the new Omicron. Omicron, let's see, okay. So I'm going to share the screen. Share, there you go. Share screen, window. Okay, so you guys should hopefully you'll be able to see the PowerPoint presentation. So I want to talk about Omicron origination. So everybody was asking, oh, how did the Omicron thing develop? You know, virus mutate, right? So, but when virus mutate, it is always similar to the family of the same viruses. For example, like Delta, Alpha, Beta, all these variants, when it came over, it was like surrounding the same kind of family of mutations. But this Omicron is like completely different. You know, if you can't hear me or something, just let me know. But I'm just going regarding these comments. So this Omicron is completely different from the other mutations that we have seen in the past. What has happened is, so then that begs the question, how did this happen? Did China bio-war this mutation again, or was that to start with? But scientists are saying that this origination is from a HIV positive patient, most likely. And this patient contracted COVID like 6 months ago. And then because of his immunocompromised state, because the immunity is so low, the virus just kept on staying for a long time and did not get out of the system, and then slowly started to mutate, and it is coming out. It is thinking that it is Bahubali. We only know that it is nothing, just Prabha's picture alone. Okay. But that is how it originated. That is what people are thinking. Okay. So why do virus mutate? So if virus doesn't mutate, then it will die, right? It will die. So virus doesn't want to die. Virus will survive until as much as it can, right? Till the last, it's the last tail ender. Like, you know, when some 90s kids will know Anil Kumble at the end of the 11, you know, he'll keep on batting until he's out. And even though if it is like, you know, he doesn't score any runs. So similar to that, this virus is trying to survive as much as possible with different mutations, so that, you know, all these vaccines and everything, it is having one hope in life that it might evade the vaccine and then cause even more pandemic, which is not going to happen. But unfortunately, and the virus ikku theriyala paavam yaaru patta pillayo romba kashtapadu. Omicron is completely different from Delta. We talked about that, right? But how it is different is PPT is not clear. Why it is not clear? Okay, udunga. I am not clear as well why it is not clear. But I will repeat this to you so that you guys will understand. So basically what I am trying to say is, the mutation is in the spike protein. Okay, so remember, we talked about this COVID virus for the last 18 months. Everybody knows about the spike protein more than the syllabus. All these online class students know about COVID-19 microbiology more than their max class. Every channel that you open, you have Omicron, spike protein, COVID-19. And the online max teacher is saying, please do my homework as well. See, that is what is happening throughout the year. Okay, present it as a slideshow. That's fine, I'll figure that out later. But anyway, so the point of the matter is the spike protein, previously the Delta mutation, we know why the virus has spike protein, like through the spike protein, it is trying to enter the cells. So now we know, okay, you know what, this is the spike protein that is a problem. So we got the antibodies through the vaccine. So the vaccine antibodies is covering the spike protein. So now the virus is trying to change the spike protein in a different way so that our vaccine antibodies doesn't recognize it. And that is how Delta formed. Delta had like 10 mutations, which means that the spike protein was like crooked like this, was downward like this, and upward trending. Design now on the Delta variant. Design on the Delta variant. So now what is happening is compared to Delta variant, 10 mutations, so now it is 50 mutations and it is around the spike protein. So when we first heard the news, I was concerned as well. I was like, what the why this is happening so much and so large with 50 mutations around the spike protein. So all the good things that we have done so far is going to backfire. But fortunately, what has happened is in that 50 mutations, only one mutation is very, very critical, and that is they call the 290E mutation or something like that on the spike protein. So that is the only mutation that is actually might be concerning a little bit, but all the other mutations looks like, you know, it is manageable by the vaccines that we have. So does our body recognize this mutation? So far it is 50-50. Okay, so right now we are able to recognize it a little bit with the vaccination. It is increased, but we still don't know the complete detail. That is what is the true answer. But most likely, we'll be able to identify and fight against this pretty soon. So how severe is this Omicron? So based on the recent data that we have from South Africa, as you guys all know, you must have known by this time that Omicron severity is very mild, right? So even for vaccinated people, they get it. So one other point I wanted to clarify is people are thinking that if you're vaccinated, you will not get COVID. That is not true. You guys know this. You have been following this channel for a long time. If you're vaccinated, if you get COVID, it will go away in 2 to 3 days. If you're not vaccinated, if you get COVID, it will persist for 2 to 3 months. So that is what the problem is. And sometimes hospitalization and death rate can happen in unvaccinated people. The same thing can happen in Omicron as well. Okay. Omicron as well. So how severe is Omicron? So far, even if it comes in vaccinated people, the severity has been very mild. In unvaccinated people as well, there has been no increased death rates or increased hospitalization so far. But we know about this variant only for 2 weeks, right? So usually think about how COVID progresses. When you get infected with COVID, the first 14 days, you are doing okay. You know, most of the time, the cytokine storm hits only after the 10th day. So it is too early to conclude, but based on the initial reports, looks like the Omicron might be a little bit less severe compared to Delta. That is what we are hoping for, and that is what is going to happen as well. Vaccine escape. So will this escape the vaccination protection that we have through all these vaccines? This is what the main reason for this YouTube live. Okay, I want my YouTube audience, my YouTube family to know this. Yes, we are protected with vaccination, but the vaccine efficacy is definitely decreased with this Omicron variant, right? It is slightly though, but it is decreased compared to before. So this mutation, the virus mutation, has done something to the vaccine efficacy, though we cannot deny it. But the end outcome has been like okay so far. So how do we counteract all this? That is why we have been recommending booster dose, right? So when the antibody level is high, the likelihood of responding to this Omicron variant is high as well. So Pfizer, what they have figured out is after 6 months of the second dose of mRNA vaccine, the immunity goes down. So that has been like very clear. So that is why we have been boosting with Pfizer vaccine one more time. But now what they have found out that Pfizer booster have increased the antibodies more than 25 times fold. And this definitely neutralized the Omicron antibodies, but not with the first two doses. So it's a good and bad news. Good news is we know that Pfizer booster is going to work. And if Pfizer booster works, every other vaccine should work as well. It is just a matter of time that we're going to get data from the other vaccines. Pfizer has always been first in revealing the data. So that is the good news. bad news is only the booster is destructing the virus, but not the first two doses. That is actually a bad news in my opinion. So that is why it is absolutely important that we boost our protection with whatever dose that we have, right? So we are almost, I remember when I was growing up, I used to stand in line to get ticket for a cinema tickets. So let's say that if you don't get a ticket for one show, like my favorite actor Rajinikanth, that's okay. I'll go and see some other show at the same time, right? So it is okay. It is okay to get any kind of vaccine as a booster now. That is how things have changed now. So I know I have told this before that, you know, mix and match is not good. We don't recommend, you know, a vaccine is like an engagement. You got to marry to the same girl. But now the situation is the girl is changing. The girl itself doesn't want to be with us. So that is why we are saying that that's okay. The engaged girl is gone. That's okay. Any girl who is ready to marry us, we will marry. That is what the situation right now is. So let's go over the situations of what are the booster doses available. So I want to talk about this equal vaccine availability. I'm very sick and tired of all these unvaccinated people here in US. 1 in 2 people are not getting vaccinated. And if I ask them, why are you not vaccinated? They give this big lecture for like 1 hour that I don't have time. I said, instead of this 1 hour, I'm so scrambling for time that I will actually do a YouTube live. So I'm sick and tired of unvaccinated people. One more thing I want to tell you was there was a YouTube channel who wanted me to do an interview with them, and that channel is actually supporting unvaccinated group. அது வந்து நம்ம வடிவேல் மாதிரி ஆகி போச்சு. டே, என்னை அடிச்சு நீங்க பெரிய ஆளாக பாக்குறீங்களாடா, வரமாட்டேன் அப்படின்ட்டு. பட் நான் அடி வாங்காத ஏரியாவே கிடையாது. இதெல்லாம் சும்மா சர்வசாதாரணம். But the concept is the equal vaccine availability. So we have so much vaccines lying around, and in Africa only less than 10% of vaccines are, less than 10% of people are double vaccinated, and there is huge vaccine availability discrepancy. If I was the president of the whole world or something like UNICEF, I'll just take all the vaccines which is being stored in my hospital right now, and then take it everything Pfizer, Moderna, Johnson & Johnson, and give it to Africa, and then vaccinate everybody. Only then this pandemic will end. If not, it's very difficult. We'll keep on doing this masking and social distancing for a while. So coming to the booster doses. Okay, so this is what I want to talk about in detail. So what I want you to do is, first, let's say you just got one dose of Covishield or Covaxin or Sputnik or Sinopharm or Pfizer, whatever the vaccine is. If you just got one dose, your next job is to, if you want to be protected from Omicron, your next job is to get the second dose. That is, I'm just answering. I'm from Dubai. Can you talk about Sinopharm? Yes, Sinopharm as well. So remember, let me just backtrack. If you got one dose of Covishield, Covaxin, Sputnik or Sinopharm, remember all four, the first dose, your next job is to get the second dose right away. Okay, so that's pretty clear. If you follow my channel, you have to get vaccinated with two doses already. If there was an option for YouTube to unsubscribe from my channel for unvaccinated people, I will do that. Okay. And number two, after two doses of these vaccines, Covaxin, Sputnik, Covishield or Sinopharm, hear me out. Government is slowly trying to authorize boosters, slowly in India, especially, right? Slowly. But again, vaccine availability, they're focusing on the second dose more than the booster. I get it. You know, it is not a one size fits all solution. But if it was my family member, but if it was within my relative, I know we are going to be a little bit selfish. That's okay. It is survival of the fittest kind of thing right now. If there is an option of getting a booster dose with either of these vaccine around your community, even if you have to pay for it, I will get it in a heartbeat right now. So if you got two doses of Covishield, I'll get one dose of Covishield now. You have to be 6 months apart. There is no data. There is no scientific research on this yet. But by the time scientific research is out, by the time the data is out, I'm concerned that we might have missed this beautiful window. This is what exactly happened in January, February of 2021. I remember putting a video on Simbu releasing that movie. I'm calling myself Simbu fan, but I don't want to remember that movie because it was a flop. Everybody watch Manad. It's amazing. It's super hit. It's brilliant. It's brilliantly done. My Taliban Simbu is back. But on that, in January, so I said that, you know what, this is the best window to vaccinate. But, you know, we missed that window and then we got hit very badly in April. I don't think it is that as bad now, but I'm still concerned that we are having a window right now. By the time government is approving Covishield or Covaxin for the third dose or booster dose, I think we might lose this window. So especially if your parents more than 60 years of age, or if you have any other medical problem, there is no question you need to get vaccinated. But in my opinion, even if you're healthy, more than 18 years of age, I would get a dose of Covishield, Covaxin, Sputnik or Sinopharm. Even if there is no government approval, and that is my opinion. And I have talked to so many infectious disease experts and they agree with this as well. Okay, so got it. All right, so let's say that you got vaccination in India. So you got two doses of Covishield. And as soon as the international travel open, all the people here in US wants their parents to come over here to take care of the two-year-old kid. இல்லாட்டி டேக் கேருக்கு வந்து காசு கொடுத்தே வந்து சம்பாதிச்சதெல்லாம் போயிடும் போல. அப்படிதான் வந்து எல்லாரும் வந்து திங்க் பண்றாங்க. சோ அப்படின்னு கிடையாது. I'm just saying, you know, it has been a long time. You need to spend time with the family. I get it. But when they come over here, they will not have availability for Covishield or Covaxin. So it is your job is to boost them with Pfizer or Moderna. And one more request to all the Indian people over here in US, if you are having your parents come over from India, try to do a business class or a premium economy, making sure that they are comfortable as much as possible, right? You know, I've seen people developing blood clots in their legs while travel recently. I don't know why it's recent, but I've been hearing more cases like that. But I'm just saying, like, you know, premium economy or something like that, you have like lots of room to walk around. Or even if it is in a regular class, you have to walk around as much as possible so that, you know, you don't develop this clots in the legs. That is the point. Oh, appo pal vandu business class la post pandraru appo la solladinga. I'm just saying that, you know, you need to be make them comfortable as much as possible. Namma academy la polam avanga varappa business class la varanum. That is my general opinion. So when they come over here, you need to get vaccinated with Pfizer or Moderna. That is one scenario. Second dose. After two doses of Pfizer or Moderna. So some parents are over here in US. They got two doses of Pfizer and then they are now in India. So in that situation, they need to get one dose of Covishield or Covax. And the other situation is here in US, if you got two doses of Pfizer, get the third dose of Pfizer. If you got two doses of Moderna, get the third dose of Moderna. If you get one dose of Johnson & Johnson, this is where it differs a little bit. They are recommending to vaccinate with Pfizer and not Johnson & Johnson as much as possible. But if you are, because the data is not out there. So Pfizer for Johnson & Johnson as well, or Moderna, any mRNA-based vaccines. If you get COVID, so do you need booster? Yes, absolutely. If you get COVID, you need a booster. There is no question. But the point is, before, if you remember, we talked about this. If you are infected with COVID, the booster dose is only the vaccination doses was only 3 months after. But now what they're saying is for booster, you don't have to wait for 3 months. If you get infected with COVID, you can get it as early as 2 weeks. As early as 2 weeks. Okay. So I hope that answers the questions for the booster dose. And then one other thing is, kids vaccination. I want to talk about this. I have a very close friend of mine whose son, who's 9 years old, who is right now in the hospital with the severe complication of COVID in kids called MIS-C, multi-system inflammatory complex syndrome in children. MISC, multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children. So what happens in this situation is the child gets COVID 4 weeks ago, has some fever, nausea, sore throat, and it's gone completely in 2 days. Parents are happy and they're thinking that, oh, you know what, he got infected with COVID, that's good. He developed natural immunity. The problem is 1% of patients can develop this complication called MISC, M-I-S-C, multi-system inflammatory syndrome. And unfortunately, I'm seeing right in front of me, it's a very close family friend as well. So 4 weeks after the symptoms start, it can have like abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting. The child didn't play out well. He was sleeping. He was very down in the classes. So all of a sudden, he gets high fever, not controlled with acetaminophen or Tylenol or paracetamol. And we took him to the emergency room and all his organ is damaged, heart, lungs, kidneys. It's multi-system inflammatory process. So he's currently in ICU getting treated. But good news about the whole thing is the prognosis is pretty good. He is getting better on prednisone, on IV immunoglobulins, which are all medication that suppresses the immunity. And I'm anticipating that he will get better soon in the next 1 week. But the point is, initially, I'm going to be honest with you, even when the vaccination came for kids, I was a little bit concerned. I was like, you know, kids do very well. Most of the times, should we really vaccinate them? We don't know about the long-term complication of vaccination in kids. As usual, an Indian parent, an Indian mentality, we know that anything will happen to us, it's okay. But if anything happened to kids, we will not let it go, right? So that's what we thought initially. But now, with more and more data coming in, I am completely convinced that there is no question. Every kid has to be vaccinated. There is a one post, there is a mortality rate of 0.1% with this MSC. So, you know, patients develop MSC, they can die as well. And my family friend now, sons, I'm anticipating he will get better because he's doing good. But there are few kids who can die as well. We don't want even one kid to be dead. We want to avoid that situation no matter what, regardless. So if you are on the head, on the edge between, you know, if you have a kid between 5 to 11 years of age, and if you're not sure whether you should get vaccinated or not, there is no question at all in my mind. Please vaccinate the kid. One dose, it's enough as well. If you want to, pediatric dose 5 to 11, that is going to give you such a peace of mind. And if you develop COVID, if you develop this MSC, you don't want to see your kid in that situation. I have seen that in person. I've seen so many patients in the past as well. But when it is around you, it hits you hard. So I don't want your kid to get that as well. So please get vaccinated between 5 to 11. If you're in US, get vaccinated with Pfizer or Moderna. But if you're in India, less than 18 years of age, there is no vaccine available yet, right? So that is how you have to protect all your surroundings surrounding the kid. So make sure that the people surrounding the kid are vaccinated. For example, mom and dad should be vaccinated. If you have a housemate coming into the house, they should be vaccinated as well. Grandma, granddad should get a booster as well. Schools, if they go to school, make sure that the teachers are vaccinated. Make sure that the principal is vaccinated. Ask them the vaccination rate, how many people are vaccinated in your school. And if you so I would recommend to stay away from shopping malls and travel as much as possible until we figure more about this Omicron variant. But if you have to travel at the urgently or unavoidable circumstances, please make sure that you take as much precautions as possible. Regarding kids, you need to make sure that they are being surrounded by vaccinated people. So I remember, you know, in little Buddha, when he was little, he was being surrounded by only healthy people because the king did not want the little Buddha to know that there are like poor people around because it will hurt him. That is how we need to raise our kids. Our kids should not even know the name unvaccinated. All they should know was, okay, all people are vaccinated, we will also get vaccinated. That is how they should grow. Okay, so surround your kids with vaccinated people and make them that all the people are getting booster as well. So unvaccinated people, we talked about it. It is, if you want to protect your kids, you need to But you need to make sure that all the unvaccinated people gets vaccinated. Okay, so one more thing is new ventures is Spotify podcast. I don't have time with my family, two little kids, work and everything, but I opened up a Spotify podcast as well. That is how I roll. But the reason for opening Spotify podcast is I get so many questions on my email. So I thought this podcast is a easier option to explain as well, and also update people regarding what I know, so that it'll be an easier channel to add for many people to get benefit from, rather than answering that specific question to that email as well. If you don't want your name to be mentioned, you could send in the email that don't mention my name, but usually I mention your name so that you'll feel included. So please watch out for the Spotify podcast for answering questions, and it'll also bring guests for interviews as well. Employee health, well, weight loss series talk. So I've started something new now that here in US they have this employee wellness committee. So they have me come over to the company and then talk to the employees about weight loss series. So we have been doing a three talk series. The first talk we talk about time-restricted feeding. The second talk we talk about practical difficulties, and third talk we summarize regarding how to make this as a long-term habit. So and again, all donations goes to Aishwaryam Trust. So if you are your company interested in this kind of series talk for employee wellness, please send an email to ask.pal@gmail.com. As usual, we are revamping the Aishwaryam Trust website. We will release a video on the new ventures on Aishwaryam Trust. We are opening up a new building with an extra facility for 50 more patients who we can take for long-term care, and where they have exhausted financial and medical options in detail. Okay. All right. So I hope I answered. I'm sorry. This is what I wanted to share. I'll quickly take some questions as well. I'm so sorry if I cannot answer everybody, but I'll just take the question that will be helpful for most of them. Natarajan Ramadas, thank you for joining. 60 plus group, will it give sufficient protection till booster dose given in India? We talked about this. So, sir, if you have access to a booster dose, please get it. I'm going to vaccinate my parents as well. They got two doses of Covishield. I'm going to get one dose of Covishield. I'm not sure how to arrange this. If it is a private setting, I'm more than willing to pay that as well. But if it was me, I will not wait for the government to approve the booster, which might not be the right thing, but that is what I would do. I want to be selfish a little bit as well. So, Parthiban Radhakrishnan, second dose in April. What period vaccine protection would be available? If it is Pfizer, 6 months. Covishield, we just don't know the duration, but we can anticipate 6 months with this Omicron variant. We got all this 296E mutation. I will not take a risk. So, if it is after 6 months, I will get vaccinated with a booster dose. First and second dose is good enough to protect from upcoming variant? Probably not. That is what the current situation is. Thank you, Ganesh Arjunan. 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 Spelling mistake, ah? Illa vandu adhan pera Arjunan. Sounds good. It's a very interesting name. Okay, Karthik is asking a very good question. Omicron is not scary. Do we still need the booster dose against such variant? Okay, so there is some kind of reassurance, right? So I'm reassuring you that Omicron might not be as bad, but also, you should take it with a grain of salt that we don't know about it completely. So it is not a time to let our guard go. This is the time to be like very, keep our guards up, practice what we are doing. But the only thing is, if you're vaccinated, the hospitalization death rate has been low. So until we know more about it, I will not disregard this as a very mild thing. So far, it has been reassuring and optimizing, but still, we don't know. So I would not let the guard go right away. So yes, you will definitely need a booster dose. Absolutely. You got two doses of Covishield. Can I have Covaxin as a third dose? No data yet, but mix and match has been good so far in the preliminary research studies. It might not that it might you might not be completely wrong, but there is no data. But if you want to proceed with Covaxin, I don't see a red flag in it. Venkatesh, I am a medical student. Good, perfect. Good luck with you. Let me know if I could be of any help. நல்ல பெரியவராகி நல்ல டாக்டர் ஆங்க என்ன என்ன மாதிரி ஆகாம நல்ல டாக்டர் ஆங்க நான் ஐ அம் ஆஸ்கிங் மை சன் வாட் டாக்டர் ஆர் யூ ஹி சேயிங் ஐ அம் எ ஸ்டமக் டாக்டர் ஆர் ஆர் ஹார்ட் டாக்டர் ஹி சேயிங் ஐ அம் எ யூடியூப் டாக்டர் என்ன போ என்ன கொடுமை பாருங்க Omicron only effective after the booster. Yes, absolutely. It is effective only after the booster. First two doses of Pfizer is not working, and they have confirmed it. Serum has 500 million chuck. Why booster in India has not started? We should ask Modi ji. Modi ji, please come into the play and then just give the remaining 300 million stocks to everybody. Okay, we talked about this. Yes, absolutely. Okay, we're going to skip questions on time restricted feeding for now. Okay, someone says Omicron variant will be last of its kind. I wanted to address this as well. Thank you, Srinath, for getting this question. So yes, that is how a pandemic usually ends, right? So you get this. That the new variants, and then you know it, they infect a lot more. You achieve herd immunity, so we cannot vaccinate the whole world. The herd immunity gets us to the 70% population that we usually have, 70% immunity that we usually need. But that is too early to conclude. I saw this WhatsApp forward that has been like running around that, oh, you know, we are towards the end of the pandemic. It is too early to conclude. It is promising, it is reassuring, but it is too early to conclude. Yes, we talked about that. Fail on Omicron, we don't know, but it is better to be cautious. So please get vaccinated with Covaxin or Covishield for a booster dose. Okay, so I wanted to answer this from Karthikeyan. Karthik, is there any particular vaccine fights more stronger than Omicron? We don't know. The answer is we don't know. But I'll tell you something. mRNA vaccines, Pfizer, Moderna, I think they might be a little bit more efficacious than virus-based vector vaccines like Johnson & Johnson, Covaxin, or Covishield. Doesn't mean that they are not good. They're good as well. But this might be a little bit more protective because the two reasons. One is the antibody level is pretty high. And the second thing is they can tweak the mRNA vaccines sooner than the virus-based vector vaccines. For example, in the worst-case scenario, there is a situation where, oh, you know what, there's increased hospitalization. This current vaccine is not working. The booster dose is not working as well. In that scenario, the Pfizer and Moderna in a better situation to tweak the vaccines sooner and faster, and then the vaccines will be available in 3 months to target the Omicron variant. If we are going into that situation, I don't think so. I'm not anticipating it. But in the worst case scenario, if that is the scenario, we are in good hands as well. So right now, there is no difference in any vaccines, but we do have data for Pfizer vaccines that Pfizer booster dose neutralizes the Omicron antibodies. Okay, so people have asked so many things about Dubai. I'm taking Sinopharm. Two doses of Sinopharm, go for one more dose of Sinopharm or Pfizer. If it was me, I will go for Pfizer. I will not go for the third dose of Sinopharm, but if the Pfizer is not available, I'll go for third dose of Sinopharm. லோன் ரேஞ்சர் எந்த சேனல் பாஸ் சொல்ல மாட்டேன்ல சொல்ல மாட்டேன் ஏன் நீங்க போய் என்னை அடிக்கலாம் பாக்குறீங்களா முடியாது என்னை அடிச்சு எல்லாரும் பெரியாராக நான் விட மாட்டேன் நீங்களே வந்து வர வச்சிருக்கீங்க போல ஓகே Okay, so Facebook, Shakil is asking, this virus is getting modified every year and hence we are not getting vaccinated every year. To be honest, yes, I think that is what I'm anticipating. Eppadi nam, I have told this before. Eppadi vandu nam pongalo pongal apdin varsha varsha solramo, adhe madri vaccine vaccine apdin sollittu vandu potra maari dhaan varum. Every year looks like it's going to be an annual vaccination, but that is what we do for flu shots, right? Flu shot, we get vaccinated every year. There is nothing harm in getting vaccinated every year. They say, oh, they're getting so many vaccines. Will it like bother our immunity? Nothing. It's nothing like that. You need that extra protection and our immunity will be able to handle all these vaccines. So don't worry too much about it. In case if that is the case, it is okay. It is completely okay. How did you manage answering them? Oh, the questions are, oh, yeah. To be honest, I'm scrambling for time these days. I'm being more effective. I'm organizing myself. I'm planning my day well ahead. I'm trying to squeeze all this in between. I'm so proud of myself. I'm thanking YouTube for making me more organized. So I found out that answering questions through Spotify podcast is the easier way to do. And now I have automated so many things that it is not that big of a deal at this time, but it is busy. Okay. 14 people from USA vaccinated 3 doses and also got an infection. Okay, so we talked about this before. COVID vaccination doesn't prevent you from getting COVID. The same thing will happen with booster as well. Channel supporting Anna. அது தெய்வ குத்தம் ஆச்சு. உள்ள போடுங்க சார், தூக்கி உள்ள போடுங்க சார், அவங்க எல்லாம் போலீஸ்ல பிடிச்சு கொடுங்க சார் அப்படின்ட்டு. ஓகே, all right, so let's talk about this kids thing. Okay, so we have talked about this kids thing in Spotify podcast with Dr. Neha, you know, my friend who is the infectious disease expert. You might have asked, do you have any other friend? I don't have any other friend who is specializing in infectious disease other than her, and she's pretty good, and that is why I'm bringing her in all my shows. Third wave affecting kids, online classes better option for kids. We talked about this before. The update is, unfortunately, in India, there is no vaccine available for kids less than 18 years of age. So you need to make sure that all your people surrounding the kids are completely vaccinated. Online classes is a pain. Keeping the kids in the house is a pain. You need to balance it out. Okay, so when you go out, I'm not saying don't go out at all. Go out, but make sure that they're completely protected. I mean, in terms of social distancing and masking. Don't go to temple. Don't go to a big gathering. Even if you go to this wedding and everything, make sure that they are protected as much as possible. Make sure that all the people coming to the wedding got their booster dose. And actually, if people are, you know, I know that all these weddings are happening again. If somebody is sending an invitation to you to please come to wedding, you send an invitation to them to please come to the booster dose first. You create a vaccination booster clinic in the wedding and ask them to first get the, instead of, you know, the tambulam sandaranthayum potteyum vandu vekkiradhukku badala varappa ellarkum or booster dose vandu kuduthittu okay now you can go abrin solittu adukapra saapadu podu. I think that is the way to go. Okay, okay, Rory Green is saying my friend Bob isn't vaccinated and apparently has superpowers which enables him to infect and kill vaccinated people while preserving his own life. He is very selfish. They have very superpower. They have so much power. They have so much power than the Superman. That is the problem. You live in US, ah? இப்ப என்னது காந்தி செத்துட்டாரா மாதிரி இருக்கு. Okay, so what is the mortality rate expected for the Omicron, sir? So far low, but again I'm re-emphasizing the point that usually hospitalization and death rate happens only 2 weeks later. I'm not scaring you, I'm not creating any panic. I'm just saying that initially we found about Omicron 2 weeks ago and now we know more about it. The hospitalization rates have not gone up, which means the death rates will be decreased as well. So it is too early to say, but we are on the right track. Looks like Omicron, the virulence might not be as bad as Delta, but it is too early. That is why I'm saying that this is an excellent window to get vaccinated. Please do not miss this window to get the booster dose. Please do not miss this window. I don't want another April or May episode what happened in India. I don't want that. How's your friend Saravana Kumar? You know, you think that he is a... People, oh, when I went to India, people were asking, Saravana Kumar is an imaginary person. He is not an imaginary person. He is actually a guy. You know, in the first 2 videos when I released, I just discussed the exact same questions that he asked. I'm not making this up. Then I said, okay, avanu vache senjiralam appdi solittu ella video la avanu vache senjiru. He's a true person. Okay, so if booster of COVID shield is available, can you go for a booster for other vaccine with the government hospital? Yes, absolutely. Yeah, I would do that. Meenakshi is saying that ivermectin will help when in doubt you are exposed to a positive patient. There have been like lots of debate and controversy. That itself is like another live show. But what I would say is, don't worry too much about ivermectin. If you want to take it, that's okay. But don't rely too much on it. Okay, I think we are towards the end of the show. I'm so happy looking at these comments because that is the best way to answer people. Look at this. One person is answering the other person that yes, it is okay to take booster. That is what Dr. Pal said. I love it. I mean, it doesn't have to be from me. We are all like one group. We are all like one team, right? We are like Team India, Team US. So it doesn't matter, it has to be coming from me. So if you can spread this information, you can start your own YouTube channel and I will include that channel in my channel as well. Okay, so I'm ready to promote. This is not my only, I'm not doing this for income. I told you this so many times. Please, please spread this information as much as possible. Get vaccinated, get many people vaccinated. I love this. This is absolutely beautiful. Okay, so I think there are lots of questions. I'm so sorry, I'm not able to answer everybody. So this one is a good thing. What was the side effects after Omicron? Omicron clinical effect is slightly different from the previous one. Tiredness, fatigue. Everybody is so tired with this Omicron, based on the news as well, but also when it gets infected, you get tired as well. So my wife Priya was like, "Oh, I think I got Omicron because I'm tired today. Can you take care of the dishes?" That's what I thought. So fatigability was the main symptom that people are seeing in South Africa. Your mail ID, doctor, askdocpal@gmail.com. askdocpal@gmail.com. Sputnik versus against Omicron variant. Again, two doses of Sputnik. Please get the booster dose as well. We talked about this. Yes, you can take. Saravana Kumar, how are you? நீங்க கண்டிப்பா எடுக்கிறமே எடுக்க மாட்டீங்களா வேக்சின் எப்படி எடுக்கிறீங்க பரவாயில்ல இட்ஸ் ஓகே வை பூஸ்டர் டோசஸ் ரெக்கர் கோ பேக் டு தி ஸ்டார்டிங் ஆஃப் திஸ் சேனல் ஸ்டார்டிங் ஆஃப் திஸ் வீடியோ அண்ட் தென் யூ ஹேவ் தி ஆன்சர் கோச்சுக்காதீங்க சார் எதுக்கு ஐ டோன்ட் இக்னோர் பீப்புள் இட்ஸ் ஜஸ்ட் தட் லாட் ஆஃப் கமெண்ட்ஸ் அ பிக் ஹாய் டு யூ தேங்க்யூ ஃபார் சப்போர்டிங் ஓகே வைஷ்ணவ் இஸ் ஆஸ்கிங் வாட் இஸ் த டைம் கேப் டு டேக் த பூஸ்டர் டோஸ் ஆஃப்டர் செகண்ட் டோஸ் ஆஃப் கோவிஷீல்ட் 6 months 6 months Bala Nagarajan, I'm also from Ellis Nagar, my native. Yeah, enna moda neenu? Is booster and regular one dose are same or different? Same. Same dose. The dose is same as well. So so please don't worry about the dosage. How do you feel about people who refuse any vaccine? Tyree is asking. I don't know whether I should answer this politically correct. Or in the YouTube channel, if somebody supervises me and then, you know, like takes my medical license away. But I don't care. I'm actually, initially, I feel, to be honest, I was very pity. I was very sad about these people initially. I was like, oh, you know what? These guys don't know what they're doing. Poor people. We need to educate them. So I need to, I usually send my YouTube channel link video to all my patients. And that's the reason I got 250,000 subs, close to 200,000 subscribers. That's a different story. but I used to send my YouTube video link to everybody. I said, oh, you know, please see this. Look at this. This is what the data is. You need to get vaccinated. And then 2 weeks later, they get admitted in the hospital. That's a different story. But now I don't talk to them at all. You don't get vaccinated. That's it. I feel so bad that. I feel so bad that this is because of this group that we are in this soup, right? There are so many people dying. Look at April, May, what happened in India? Everybody, every one of their family member died. Any distant family member. Death, it is not. I mean, I lost my cousin, 40-year-old. He has two little kids. And I can guarantee you that if we are vaccinated, we would not have been in this situation. And I don't want such thing to happen again, ever, to any family. And you know, these I feel so angry about these unvaccinated people that I just wanted to, what do I say? If I was Bahubali and I was just wanted to lift them like in one hand and just throw them away. Seriously, I don't pity them anymore. I don't pity them anymore. And you know, I know this is not a politically correct answer, but that is what the anger in me. And I feel so, what do I say? That why should one of the vaccinated people who's ready to get vaccinated, die because of this Omicron, right? Because of these guys. Because of these guys, Omicron will come. The next Omicron 3 will come. And then Omicron 4 will come, right? And we're just sick and tired of this. I know that's a good question, Tyree, that you ask. If you know the solution to this is, if you're in US, I'll tell you the solution. The solution to this is all the health insurance company will say that I will not pay a penny for people who are not vaccinated. If you're not vaccinated, if you get COVID, if you get hospitalized, I will not pay for your insurance. You pay out of your pocket. If you don't have money, you go there and then you work for the next 10 years and then you pay. I know I'm very crude and brutal, but that is how I feel about these people. You know, we are in this soup because of these people. In India, if you're not vaccinated, tell them that go and watch. I don't want to tell the actor's movie, but some movie that is a really a floppy movie. But don't, I'm telling you that, you know, these unvaccinated people are the reason for this whole Omicron variant. And there is no forgiveness anymore. We have been dealing with this 18 months. I cannot forgive unvaccinated people anymore. So all I can do is to try to promote vaccination, and all I can do is to have unvaccinated people unsubscribe from my channel. But anyways, I mean, that's how we are. I mean, you know, okay, so the other thing is look at US distributions, right? So if you look at the vaccination group and unvaccinated group, it is exactly similar to the election results of 2021. All the blue states, all the Democrats are vaccinated, all the red states, all the Republicans are vaccinated. At least in US, I can understand that, oh, you know, freedom of thought, freedom of speech, you know, it is important, but you know, it has to be controlled at some level, right? But in India, freedom of speech is important, but still, there are like 10% of people who are still not getting vaccinated, right? Because of like lots of things. And I don't feel bad for the uneducated people who don't know about the benefits of the vaccine, but I cannot forgive the vaccinated educated people. People who are working in the software companies in India, and you know, they read some like Google websites, and then the way that they talk as if they found a vaccine for COVID in this get-togethers and promoting people not to get vaccinated is the next sin. They should all be jailed and they should all be given like severe punishments. So if you go to a get-together and somebody's talking about educated people, they have a degree and they're talking about unvaccinate, don't vaccinate, report them to the police. I think that is what you should do. Okay, that wasn't a very emotional and long answer, but I hope that emphasizes the importance of vaccination. All right, so, oh, good. I forgot about this donation. Krishna Acharya, he donated for Aishwaryam Trust. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We are releasing a video on Aishwaryam Trust on regarding what we are doing and how your money is going for them to get to the next level. Okay, I'll take one last question. Okay, I'll take this question and then I will wrap up. Okay, so Anirudh Ramesh is asking, give me a proof of vaccination helps reduce COVID. Israel got the highest vaccination rate and only vaccinated people got COVID, right? Okay, so the answer to this is there is multiple research studies that vaccinations have decreased the transmission. Not completely, not completely. I agree with you, not completely, but the percentage has decreased significantly, which we will take it, right? The transmission rates from vaccinated people, if it goes down, that's good. That is why we want everybody to get vaccinated. Israel got the highest vaccination rate and only vaccinated people got COVID. The reason that we know about the data is they vaccinated completely. 85% of people got vaccinated. Do we have the number? Do we have the number here in the US? Only 55% got vaccinated. In Israel, they got 85% got vaccinated, right? So if again, vaccinated people, I mean, vaccination will not prevent you from getting COVID. They will get COVID. They will get COVID, but the severity is extremely low. You look at my hospital now, again, it is flooding up. 12 people are in ICU now. Everybody is intubated, and everybody is unvaccinated, and 3 people are going to die. And they are on the deathbed. And all the family is like crying outside, right? So one vaccination, even one dose, they would not be in this situation. And we know that vaccination prevent deaths, right? So your argument of vaccinated people also got COVID is not right. They get COVID. They will get COVID, right? Breakthrough infections are supposed to happen. That is how the system works. Supposed to happen, but they will not die. Which one is better, death or getting COVID? I think getting COVID is much better, right? And we can also stop getting COVID if all the other people got vaccinated as well. And that is why we are promoting all this. All right, sounds good. I think I'm all done up with my ranting and everything. So I will see you in the next live session. As I said, I'm scrambling up for time. I will try to be organized as much as possible and I will update you. Please send your questions to askdocpal@gmail.com. I will try to club things together and answer it in the Spotify podcast that is also available in Google and Apple in the next couple of days. All right, stay safe, get vaccinated. We will talk about time-restricted feeding. And the next topic that I'm going to release a video is on gut bacteria. How gut bacteria is very, very critically important for everything, especially weight loss. I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.